But
so, I mean, I get it. That's where.
Six will be quick, whatever the board's preference is.
Whatever you want to do, as a preface to what may happen, the issue on six is the candidate position is no longer an issue, therefore the appeal is irrelevant whether it's granted or it's moot. The issue is whether or not a cup application go forward. It is going forward, so that the issue moved.
Okay, and let me say this. We may lose a board member depending on the time, but the rest of the board would like to finish it. Is that correct?
Yeah.
If at all possible. This evening?
Yes.
Or probably part of tomorrow. So let's do six and get it over with. And then we'll do seven. I make a motion that we open the public hearing for AP180006. Do I have a second?
Second.
Have a second. All those in favor? Unanimous.
This request involves an appeal of an administrative decision of Forsyth County Department of Planning and Community Development.
All right, I believe we've already said it's been agreed to the exhibits 1, 2, and 3 through 15, which were admitted in the first hearing, will be admitted in this hearing. Opening statement, Mr. Bose.
Yes, thank you, Commissioner. So this is AP8006. This is for the no site visit requirement. So I appeal because there was a determination from the county director that you need a site visit. And so I appealed that decision that he needs a site visit. I actually wrote some emails back and forth, and I have all that evidence here. And so I'm going to submit this whole stack into evidence of emails and my correspondence.
If please, the board will object on the sense of that issue is no longer an issue. There's no need to go forward with any particular presentation of evidence. Our director's here, he's not insisting on that particular issue for the application to go forward. There's nothing to consider at this time.
So I would like a ruling if the director can ask arbitrarily for a site visit to a property for an application. And
we can only rule on the appeal, you know, the administrative appeal. We're not really giving instructions to the director or anything in the future.
Okay, so I'm submitting this into evidence.
Wait a minute.
This is opening statement. All you're doing, Mr. Bose, is just telling what you intend to prove. After Mr. Frickey makes his opening statement, you'll have a chance to present your case. If you want to introduce anything, you can do so at that time.
I'm sorry, I thought the shots are getting this whole thing. Yeah, that's that. Okay, so I made my opening statement.
Thank you. Members of the board, there's no need for evidence or testimony or anything. The county is acknowledging in this particular case that is not insisting on the requirement which is being appealed, therefore, nothing to be heard, no evidence needs to be presented, and he has withdrawn the obligation to meet on the site in order to allow the CUP application to go forward. That's what I'm going to say. Hopefully there would be no need for any presentation of evidence to that.
Based on those comments, how would you suggest that the board rule on this?
Okay, that's our
turn. Well, I'm asking.
Well, that's a good question. I'm asking the same thing. Are you not opposing his appeal? Are you basically consenting to his appeal?
The county would turn it phrase. The county does not believe there is any issue that I don't believe the appeal is I believe the appeal is moot. We move to dismiss the appeal based on it being moot. The issue is no longer subject to consideration. So actually, I guess the county's position would be to move that it the appeal be dismissed.
Does Mr. Bose?
Hey.
Sorry. Do you understand what he's saying?
Yes, I disagree. I'm the one who appealed. He can't dismiss
it. I understand it. I understand what he's saying. He's saying that the county basically agrees with you and that not that the appeal is dropped, but they're consenting.
That's exactly what I said. This is okay. Very fast. So I want your ruling, like you do, you know, AA and whatever you're doing here, to rule on this appeal.
Okay.
So, Can I present my evidence, Mr. Neville?
We don't have anything to present.
Oh, I do want my evidence and record, sir.
Okay.
So you can rule on it.
The county is saying that basically you don't have to do what they ask you to do.
But
so there's you don't need to present anything.
But I am the one who's appealing, sir.
He's looking for some ammunition or something else.
Yeah. So we won't rule on it.
Okay. I'm not withdrawing my appeal. I want to put my evidence into record. And y'all have the right to deny it or what do you call that?
Affirm it,
yes. So that's your choice. The whole thing.
All right.
Thank you. Shall I give closing statement?
I'm going to object with that.
For
lack of foundation would be the objection, but for purposes of this, for this appeal only,
I'm not going to object, but still move to dismiss on the grounds of moot issue.
All right. I'm going to have this marked as B1. No objection.
Specifically called out in the rules, but same time, I assume we're going to get some testimony if we don't.
I think maybe our third option might address what something that can get us moving forward.
Yeah, I mean, there's the rules don't even contemplate a motion to dismiss, but if you want to go ahead and make that motion, you can go ahead.
The county's moved to dismiss the objection for which the appeal is, or the decision which the applicant is appealing is effectively rescinded and is no longer in effect. Therefore, there's no basis for the appeal. Therefore, the issue is moved to dismiss the appeal on that ground. They still have gotten what they
basically
wanted.
Basically, the county reversed itself.
Okay. We understand what you're saying.
Okay.
This would be the equivalent of finding the plaintiff or the appellant, the appealer, insane. Same with that. They get what they want.
Yeah. I mean, I'll leave that as that one way of looking at it, perhaps.
Okay. Thank you. So we've got this option. It's not in the book, Alfred.
As a practical matter, yes, the board has the option to make a finding that you agree with the applicant.
Can we also suggest that we postpone so the county attorney makes a determination on how to proceed with this?
No, he's already right.
Let me ask you this. Can we just find against the county and move forward?
Just reverse it.
Just reverse it.
Because that's really what the county did.
Well, the option is to find that the director was clearly erroneous in his interpretation, administration, or enforcement of the rule. That's the language of the rules. But in this case, it sounds like you've got a situation where the director and the county are conceding the position of the applicant and agreeing with the position of the applicant. So.
The hesitation is I don't want maybe semantics, I don't want the county necessarily to be placed in the position of saying they agree with the application. We just have established that there is no need for the appeal either. For whatever reason, that decision has been rescinded. There is no such decision to be appealed. Slight semantical difference, but that is the county's position.
So I appeal based on something that happened. The question is, are you going to take my appeal or are you going to keep skirting the issue? That's the question on the table.
But we're not skirting the issue.
So you have to rule on it.
No, if the county has reversed its decision, you've gotten what you were appealing for.
So it's
without
like
it.
No. No, that's not right. That's not right at all. What I'm appealing is, so this doesn't happen to me again. So you got to rule on this. Just because they anyway. Okay, so
it has nothing to do with anything in the future.
It's got everything to do, sir. These are the very same type of rules that everybody adjusts, and I'm simply requesting that I appeal. Y'all have to rule per your rules. Affirm or deny. I'm fine with either one. Please do one or the other. Thank you.
That's my closing.
Taking his application, straight from his, what was the decision that's now subject to appeal? Written notification, verbal decision February 28, 2018, written notification March 12, 2018. Appellant is appealing this decision. That decision doesn't exist anymore. The future, if he were to appeal, file that appeal today, it would be rejected because there is no such appeal, right, of this board. The board can't issue advisory opinions as Mr. Shoemake, Mr. Chairman, you have the knowledge.
I'll offer a motion Rich, would you help?
I don't understand. I mean, I don't really understand what the county is saying. Is the way the rule is written, you'd almost have to hear this evidence to decide whether the director was clearly erroneous or not. If the county is not opposing the application, then I think you make a decision in favor of the applicant and move on.
We have a third option, which it allows us to modify the action. Would that be applicable?
Is his contention that there is no such requirement in Section 8 of the UDC for a site visit prior to a conditional use permit? Is that accurate? Is what he says there accurate? You're saying it went away, but is it not there?
I honestly am not prepared to present any evidence one way or the other because there's nothing for this board to decide, so I honestly, I'm at a loss for why we're appealing something that doesn't exist.
It's a show.
Let me help you. There isn't. Thank you.
There is not.
There isn't.
You're saying that we can just find for the appellant, or excuse me, the applicant.
In this situation, I would say.
All right.
Based on the county not presenting any evidence.
We haven't reached that point yet. Ask that the board deny the appeal based on the lack of existence. If we go that far, if he's unwilling, I mean, can't agree that the county can't agree that the grounds are correct for the appeal. We don't.
I think you guys will take 5 minutes and explain to Mr. Bose.
I would honestly love to and have tried.
Okay.
And tried through. I have tried for weeks to get this.
The appeal, that it just goes away. Do you understand that, Mr. Bones?
I'm sorry.
Do you understand that if you withdraw, if you on 006, if you withdraw your appeal, it just goes away, as if nothing ever happened?
In this instance, it may. But you leave that to precedence, I'm not willing to do it, sir.
But there will be no precedence.
Oh, sir, I have a ton of applications you'll see in the rest of it. So it's going to happen again and again. So I need a verdict from y'all. I'm not withdrawing my my appeal.
We can argue this forever.
Correct.
Let us just hear the evidence and move forward.
All right, Mr. Bose, present your evidence.
Oh, I'm sorry, what are we doing now?
Present your case.
Oh, okay. Can I have the stack back, please? Thank you.
I had assumed that this case was going to be a simple exercise. I would ask that the agreement to tender evidence, if we're going to hear evidence, I would like the evidence to reflect appropriate foundation in this case and be relevant to the particular issue. I haven't seen it. I still have not seen the evidence.
You've already agreed to admit it without objection.
So I'm going to really make it fast here in terms of this. I was forced to apply for a conditional use permit for adding a residence on a farm. You all saw the drawing where the little barn is with the little residence on it. And through this process, it was a long process because I jumped through all those hoops to get to where we were at the last stage where it was going to the Board of Commissioners. And this was on February 27th or 28th. And we got a letter from Ms. Leslie downstairs saying that the director determined that a site visit is necessary. And without a site visit, it won't go forward. So I sent emails back and forth about this site visit. And I said, OK, I filed an appeal. After I filed an appeal, they changed or did whatever they did. So my appeal came before for the county withdrawal. If I did not appeal and pay the $350, nothing would have happened. I would have been screwed again on that application and would have continuously gone on. So I did it correctly, and the appeal precedes the withdrawal. And now this is the interesting part. I actually filed and I gave the appeal, but it was not stamped until after the withdrawal happened. That aside, there are emails that I have here which I'm going to present. This is a letter from Ms. Leslie as to why, how they came to needing the site visit. So that is what this evidence is here. And you all can take, pardon me?
Oh, are we in evidence right now? Can I see what you're going to testify to?
Pardon?
Can I see what you're going to testify to?
Oh, this is it.
No, I haven't seen it.
Yeah, sure. It's part of the application. So. It's part of the application.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, get that. Can keep talking while we're going. This all started with my requesting. We had this trailer on the property. It's been there since the time the barn was born. And late in 2016, we took it out to do the refurbishment and repairs on it. So in that process, at the same time, the Sony power guy came with that wire exposure thing. And he said, so what are you going to put there? I said, we'll bring the trailer back. He said, why don't you, till then we had only the commercial power box. So he said, why don't you apply for residential for the trailer? I came to the county and he said, go get a permit for it, it's very simple.
This I'm going to object, if we're talking about a trailer on the property, that wasn't the decision that was made. We're talking about a cup permit.
We're talking about a cup.
Correct. Exactly. And this is what started the cup. I'm giving you the foundation of what started the cup. I can just go ahead and put this
on the evidence. Tell the board what you're appealing. So.
That's what I'm appealing. So I went through this process starting on August 24th of 2017. And it goes on till March where they finally determine that they need a site visit after everything has been approved to go to the Board of Commissioners. So that kept pushing the date going backward. This happens all after this stop work orders. So it's all happening at the same time, but after. So I appealed and they reversed, but my appeal preceded the application. So that's it. It's all in evidence. Please take your time to go through it if you want to. And here I tender into evidence. Thank you. Yeah.
Before that goes away, let's hear it.
I may not understand.
Mr. Bose, you want to come back up here?
Oh, sure.
Last sentence you.
Last sentence you closed with, I believe, was I appealed the reverse. That was after the application?
No, after the appeal.
After the appeal.
Yeah.
So after you filed this appeal, AP180006, county reversed its decision.
County said, yes, no, we will let the thing go without the site visit that they determined just a few weeks before that, or a month before that.
Okay.
You can see the timeline.
And it is scheduled to go before the Board of Commissioners on July 5th, correct?
Yes, sir.
So there is no pending decision by the county that requires you to get a site visit before the board considers your CUP application, correct?
I don't know. That is why I want a ruling from
you. Are you aware of one?
I don't know. What will get hit after we go from
so
here?
So you don't know, as we stand here today, yes, whether or not there is a decision outstanding that requires you to have a site visit in order to, for the board to consider your CUP application?
I don't know, but I won't doubt that there won't be one of a similar nature.
As of today, as we stand here tonight,
yes,
still tonight,
yes,
is there a CUP application proceeding to the board?
Yes.
And is that the same application that's the subject of appeal AP180007?
Yes.
This one,
this one.
Yeah. I'm gonna take a look at it. Sit over here to make sure it's
okay. Is that anything further?
No, I don't have any. Right. Thank you.
County, you want to present your case? Frickey, you can stay in your place, whatever.
Thank you. I will say in my place that there is no pending decision that would require Mr. Bose to subject himself to a site visit in order for a CUP application for his CUP application to proceed to the Board of Commissioners. It is in fact scheduled on the July 5th hearing. That's all the county has with respect to this application.
I guess sticking with procedure, anyone here to speak in favor or in opposition to the appeal, come forward. hearing nothing, final argument.
Actually, I have a question for Mr. Frickey. If the county hadn't withdrawn, then what would the county's position be on this?
I honestly have not given that thought. I did not expect to go even this far with it.
Fair enough.
No, that's, I just need a verdict from you all. Thank you.
As a final closing statement, I would actually ask, it is within, we've gotten this far. At this point in time, I'd ask this board to actually deny the appeal based on the grounds that there is no such decision. Mr. Bose himself admitted that the county has already said reversed the decision. There is nothing for this board to consider. There is nothing to affirm at this point in time. The only choice this board has is to deny the appeal. So we'd actually ask at this point in time, having gone through these steps in the process, we'd ask the board to deny the appeal. Thank you.
Mr. Edwards, that goes back to your question of whether there's anything in the county that lets you do this. This is precisely why you all need to look at this appeal and affirm it, but leave it up to you.
Thank you.
All right, let's do that. Yes.
I make a motion that we close the public hearing.
Second.
For AP180006. We have a motion and a second. All those in favor? Gentlemen, you've heard quite a bit about this. There really is no decision here. County's withdrawn the requirement.
Can I make a motion?
Yes, you may.
To have the discussion and
yes,
that, that might clarify. I move that the board affirms the county's decision for appeal application AP 180006.
I'll second.
We have a motion and a second. Any discussion at this point?
I had come to that conclusion before Mr. Frickey spoke, in that the county made a decision, they rectified the decision, came out, and so therefore their ultimate decision was that he did not require the site visit, so therefore is correct.
That's not what's in here.
But evidence has been presented that it's been corrected. And there was no evidence presented to say whether there was a site visit actually required, nor was there any evidence cited that there wasn't one required. So
you can affirm the ruling that's in here, but you can't affirm something that came after.
See, I'm back to the, was it egregious, and I don't see it as that.
Rich, question.
Let me
within the appeal, a cup is required, a site is required for a cup. Within the appeal, the county has changed its position now. If we affirm the county's position, are we affirming the decision that was in the appeal, or are we affirming the current decision?
Well, here's the problem. There's really not, in the rules, there's not a rule that applies to this situation. As I understand it, the county had a requirement and then it changed its rule. And so now that requirement that Mr. Bose appealed is no longer a requirement. So in that sense, it's moot. I would agree with Mr. Frickey. I didn't understand the facts of it before, but I think it is a moot decision. I think the board is believe the county, the board can decide under the rule that the director's decision was clearly erroneous. But I'm not sure that's what the evidence was. I think the evidence was, for whatever reason, the county decided to change its rules.
We have a motion. We have a second. I am very
What if we modified
that's what I was thinking.
The decision to go with the county's current rules? That way it's neither affirming it or reversing it. It's saying we're going with the current rules. Because that's what the modified decision is.
My original plan was to modify to say that the decision was moot, but everybody said we needed to hear evidence and all that kind of stuff. So.
Okay.
All right. We have a motion. We have a second. Would you like to withdraw your motion?
No.
Would you like to withdraw your second?
I'll withdraw my second.
Is there another second? Motion fails for lack of a second.
No.
Is there another motion?
Give me a second. Mr. Chairman, I move that the board modify the decision to appeal to state that the county has withdrawn its requirement for a site visit and appeal is now null and void.
Appeal is no longer
necessary. Is no longer necessary.
I'll second.
I have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? All those in favor of the motion?
One last comment.
Oh, okay.
I don't think there was any evidence presented that indicated that there was any, the county's decision was egregious. They just chose to change their mind.
And I agree with that.
And that's what this says.
That's what he is.
Okay.
All those in favor of the motion? Got three.
I actually abstain.
Okay, that's fine. All right, well, excuse me. All those opposed? One opposed, one abstention. And Alfred has other commitments, work commitments, and he needs to go. The rest of us will stay a while.